the gun down. Sheriff's office, drop it.
I'm gonna grab my long rifle.
You do not know where I am.
Hey, on the ground.
Hey, Rick.
Put the gun down.
I'll talk to the cops.
Alright guys, welcome to tonight's patrol. For tonight, we'll be doing a valley patrol. So for those who don't know, it's just basically from Harmony, just everything that's to the left of that. And yeah. Reasonable size amount of us for tonight. We have two civvies, two deputies, and one detective, so it should be interesting. No rescue, unfortunately, so just civvies refer from doing any calls involving that. So yeah, I'll be the act dispatcher, and you know, when calls comes to me, I'll welcome back to our former member, ex-rescue lieutenant Football Crusher. It's good to have you back from your leave of absence. Other than that, not much else to say. Let's just keep the professionalism and have a good patrol, as always. Let's head out there, have fun, safe patrol, serve, protect, be safe. Salute. 152.
152.
Why is that? Vehicles come back 1017, all clear. As for the individual, male white 6'1, brown. I was going to be showing a 1018 for 1032.
Then, for can you roll me one additional times one of my 1020? 1013 times one, 1020 is going to be then Coto Grande Valley in Great Chapnell.
10-4.
Alrighty, sir, how's it going?
Good.
Alright, do you mind just stepping out of the vehicle for me?
For what?
I'll explain to you right after. Step out for me.
I feel more safe sitting in the vehicle.
Alright, sir, unfortunately, I'm asking you to step out of the vehicle. And when a police officer asks you that, you have to comply to his order. Or his demand that he gives you. Understand? So if you don't want to come out, I'll just break in through that window and take you out myself and charge you for disorderly conduct and failure to comply with lawful orders given by a police officer. Alright? Alright. Do you have anything to detain you for right now? Space that way. Alright. Detained. Alright, sir, just come in and step in front of my vehicle for me.
Only one on scene.
Alright, sir, the reason why you're being detained right now is because when I ran your information, it's faced this way. Alright, so when I ran your information, alright, you came out with a felony warrant for grand theft. Possession of a stolen vehicle. Okay, of stealing a vehicle. Not this vehicle, of stealing a vehicle. Okay? Know about that?
No.
No? Okay. Just sit tight, sir. I'm just gonna speak to my partner over here.
Alright, sir, just have a seat. Have a seat in the bumper, please. Did you search him?
I'm about to do that. I just wanted to update you on what's going on.
Okay, let's just do that first for officer safety.
Yep. Alright, sir, do you have anything on you that I should know about that'll stick me, poke me, hurt me?
No.
Oh, okay. Do you have any identification on you? Oh, wait, disregard that, I already had it.
You already took it, smart fellow.
Right. As I'm searching you, what do I find?
A 3-inch knife.
Okay.
A keys to a garage.
Okay. Sir, what are you doing with this knife?
I didn't know that having knives were illegal.
Alright, well, if it's bigger than the palm of my hand, it's illegal. You're in possession of
the bigger palm, not your palm.
Yeah.
My palm.
I'm pretty sure your palm is not 3 inches, and also my palm, too. Okay.
3 inches? Do you know how big that is? That's like a size of an iPhone 6. That's less than an iPhone 6 size.
Alright, well...
So I'm pretty sure that it's smaller than that.
Okay, so, well, unfortunately... Hey, it looks bigger than your hand. In roleplay context, I'm revising here. Alright? So just...
Whatever. Just take me to jail.
Sir, why are you getting so hostile towards us? We didn't do nothing wrong.
Because I just want to go to jail. This is bullcrap, wasting my time out here. I'm going to jail, I already know I am. Bring me there so I can just hurry up.
Okay, your attitude isn't helping this situation, man. Alright, so just chill out for us, okay? We're not your bad guys. I'm not sure why you had the... Well, correction, I believe it was auto theft. Okay, we didn't tell you to steal a car, right? Just have a seat, sir. I'm gonna talk to my partner. Alright, thank you. Alright, what's the deal with him?
Alright, so I went to go pull him over. He turned at a very high rate of speed. Slightly hit me in my rear. Correction, my front. In my rear. I went to go pull him over. He was acting a little nervous and shaky. I was kind of concerned about that.
Whoa, hold on.
Okay, sir, listen, we're not talking to you. Just chill out.
Okay.
If you keep hauling, I'm going to charge you with disturbing the peace, okay? Relax.
Alright, so... When I got a 1014 and a 1015 on him. 1014 came back to 1018 for 1032. Oh, felony warrant for auto theft. And then that's basically it for now.
Was he like this the entire time? Because when I got here, I just noticed he was really defensive and stuff.
Yeah, very hostile and defensive about himself. I'm just getting a little nervous about him, a little concerned, but...
Alrighty. Well, let's just go ahead and state his charges and then bring him to jail. If you want to cut him some leeway, just feel free to not charge him with a knife. I'm not sure if he's having a bad day or whatever, but...
Alright.
Alrighty.
So I'm going to charge him for the warrant. That one?
Yep.
Alright. Alright, so just stand up for me.
Hold on. I heard you over there saying I almost hit your front.
Alright, sir, what we were talking about...
How does that make any sense?
What we were talking about does not concern you right now at this moment.
It was about me. How does that not concern me?
Sir, we weren't talking to you, okay?
I'm talking about you. Oh, okay. Okay, but you were talking about me, so it just doesn't concern me.
Sir, if you want, I could just give you a citation for speeding, too. I could just drop that
if I want to
right
now. I don't care.
Alright, man. You need to chill out for me right now, okay? Because right now you're showing
you
aggression.
Would you charge for disorderly conduct?
Bring me to jail. Yep, okay. Alright.
I'm not going
to
do it. Come on. Alright.
Okay, just charge
him. I don't care. Just bring me over there. Right. Do whatever you got to
do. Now you're being charged with disorderly conduct.
How am I being discharged for disorderly conduct?
Okay, sir, we've given you multiple chances to chill out, but you keep hollering. Like you are right now, okay?
Go to jail.
Our partner just stated his charges.
Yep. Being arrested and charged for the following. Getting a citation for speeding, disorderly conduct, and a felony warrant for auto theft. Okay? You have the right to remain silent. Anything you say can and will be used against you in the court of law. You have the right to consult to an attorney. If you got a phone, it will be appointed to you by the courts. You understand these rights? Yes or no, sir. You also have the right to plead the fifth.
I think that's what he's doing right now. Okay, that's fine. Just go ahead and stand up for me, man. Step to the back of my partner's vehicle.
Grab your arms. Glad you to the car. Hey, partner.
Wait till I open the door for you. Okay. Step in. Watch your head. All right, I'm gonna get a tow truck for the vehicle. All right. Have a good one.
Number one.
Now an operator, deem fire mess, please.
Police, there are these two individuals, hanging near the, ammunition off of, Route 68, and they've been, firing guns into, the Zancudo River, and just been shooting stuff, and been really obnoxious all night long.
Okay, so what's the description of the individuals?
Two guys, one guy wearing, it looks like, half military fatigues, you know, other dudes wearing, like, a cowboy hat, and, like, some black clothing.
Okay, sorry. All right, hang tight.
152.
Second unit to respond, code 2. It's going to be the ammunition store off of Fort Zancudo. It's in reference to two males reportedly firing weapons off into the Zancudo River. It's going to be two male individuals, one wearing a cowboy hat and black fatigue. Correction, black plaque. Second's gonna be wearing a half military uniform.
10-4, 152 and route code 2.
10-4.
All right, I see a fish right there. I'm a shoot.
Get it.
Nope.
Want a beer?
Beer? Go, Sheriff. We'll 101 show both units on scene.
Ah, it's the police.
Oh, let me handle this.
I'm getting out of here.
Nah, stay here. I'll handle this.
Hey, gentlemen. Are you... Sir, stay right there. Put the weapon down now. Shots fired. Partner, watch him.
Both of you
put the gun down. Sheriff's office, drop it.
I'm gonna grab my long arm. You do not know where I am. Hey,
on the ground.
Hey, Rick.
Put the gun down.
I'll talk to the cops.
Sir, I'm not gonna tell you again in the green. Put the gun down.
No. Calm down. All right, you guys
drop
both gotta be calm.
Right now.
You're calm, nope. I'm calm.
Partner, get the beanbag. Got him covered.
All right, easy.
On your stomach.
Drop. No. We're gonna have a civil conversation here, okay?
Get the beanbag.
Don't. You're gonna regret it.
You're gonna get shot with this beanbag in a minute here if you don't comply. Get on your stomach. Do it now.
Alright. Gets on ground.
Do not touch that weapon. Partner, cover the one in the green. I'm gonna secure the one in the black first. Puts his hand behind his back. Tackles to the ground. Puts you in cuffs. Hold on. Watch him. Let me just pat him down.
Yep.
Alright, real quick, as I'm searching, what do I find?
You find, beers. I have a beer in my pocket and two packs of smokes.
Okay. Alright, cover me.
Alright.
Wait, one more thing.
Secures the weapon.
You want me to charge this guy with public intoxication? PI.
Okay. As I'm searching, what do I find?
You find a knife and a pistol on my ankle.
Okay. Gun, partner. And a knife.
Alright. Hey, you in the cowboy hat.
Officers, we were trying to have some fun.
Do me a favor, just grab the one in the black. I'll get this one in the green. Sir, go ahead and step up to the front of my vehicle.
So why are you in...
Guides you to the car.
Grab your arm, guide you. Drunk.
We were just trying to shoot some fish.
Well, unfortunately, today you're going to have to be charged with public intoxication, PI.
Hey, have a seat. Don't talk to him. I'll handle it.
Okay, sir, have a seat.
Oh, disregard.
Whoa.
Really? Stop, RB.
What's the damn controls?
Alright, step from my vehicle, sir, in the black SUV. Cowboy hat.
Can I have another beer, please?
No, unfortunately, you cannot.
Alright, man, what are you doing? Why are you guys just out here shooting in the river?
We were blowing off some steam.
Blowing off some steam? Okay, there's nothing wrong blowing off some steam, sir, but look where you are. You're right beside a bunch of businesses, okay, which are concerned. This isn't a hunting ground. If you want to go hunting, sir, first off, you need a license to do that, so. Okay?
Okay.
And if you look over there by the mountains.
More fishing than hunting, if anything.
Okay, well, right now that's illegal, sir. You cannot hunt fish.
Yep.
You cannot hunt fish by shooting them with the shotgun or any weapons for that matter.
Says who?
Says the law, sir. And I'm not going to sit here and debate it with you all day, okay?
Alright.
Yeah. Do you have any form of identification on you?
I cannot disclose that with you.
Well, right now, when you're being contacted by law enforcement personnel, and they ask for ID, you are required by law to provide it to them. Especially
You can handle that with the military police.
Okay.
We're not part of the United States military, but we're associated with the United States military.
So. How do I even know who you are if I don't have your ID?
That's something you gotta talk to Fort Zancudo about.
Okay. I have another way of doing that. Just go ahead and stand up for me. Takes off your hat and your glasses. Puts them on the hood. Alright. Go ahead and face. Okay, stay right there.
Alright, so what are you thinking today? You're at shooting your... out in the public while being intoxicated and drinking alcohol?
I was shooting some fishies.
You were shooting some fishies? Where were you? Alright, so you have any identification on you?
That's none of your business, isn't it?
Alright, so right now first, before I ask you that, I'm gonna search you.
Go for it. Your partner already did that, but okay.
Oh, you already did it? Alright. Alright. So you're out here shooting fish, right?
Mm-hmm.
And you're drinking at the same time. So how about this? I could charge you.
You do what you want to do.
Okay, and public intoxication by me taking you to jail.
You do you. I was just trying to have some fun out here.
Alright, just sit tight.
Mr. Football Crusher, is it?
Maybe.
Okay, well, I ran your name. It comes back to you. So, if you want to continue to lie to me, sir, I'm just going to charge you with obstructing official business. Maybe isn't a valid answer, okay?
Information with you.
Alright. So, you guys stated you guys are fishing. Is that correct? With shotguns?
It wasn't a good fishing attempt, but we made the best. We didn't have any fishing hooks with us, so, you know.
Do you know it's legal to be in possession of a firearm while intoxicated? Regarding your buddy over there, because he could barely stand up.
I'm not intoxicated. My buddy is another answer. Okay.
Right. So why are you letting him shoot guns if he's intoxicated?
He does his own thing. You know, he's a big guy. I mean, you know, I try and stop him. He starts hitting me. I get unconscious, and, you know. I end up in a motel room somewhere.
Oh. Sounds like a good friendship or bond you guys have. Mm-hmm. Alright, just go ahead and sit tight. I'm gonna talk to my partner, then we'll let you know what's gonna happen.
Alright.
Alright.
Jeez. One sec, partner, I'm just gonna grab my jacket.
Yep. I'm gonna grab mine too.
Alright, so, what did, your guy state?
Alright, so, number one, he's in possession of a weapon while intoxicated, and I'm also gonna charge him for public intoxication. Same time. Mm-hmm. I'm gonna get a 1014 on him, unless he doesn't refuse, that's what he's trying to do right now. But if he fails to do so, I'll just get a 1023.
Exactly. They're just being a pain in the ass right now, not wanting to comply or answer anything. That's fine. There's other ways to go about this, so I'm just gonna charge my guy. He's all clear, but I'm gonna charge him for misconduct involving a firearm. They're shooting the fishes, basically. I guess that's their form of fishing, which is completely illegal, so. And he's not wanting to really cooperate, so I'm just gonna also charge him for obstructing and misconduct involving a firearm.
I charge that guy too with the obstruction or no?
Well, one of them actually shot. I believe it was this guy. When he ran from us or jumped over the fence, I heard a couple shots go off, which I believe was his because he did have a machine gun.
And I charged him for unlawful use of discharge of a firearm.
Just unlawful use and just public intoxication.
Alright.
Okay. Alright. Mr. Football Crusher, go ahead and stand up for me.
Mm-hmm.
Alright, so right now, sir, I am going to be placing you under arrest for misconduct involving a firearm and obstructing. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
You have the right to remain silent. If you give up that right, then anything you say can or be against you in the court of law. You have the right to an attorney. If you cannot afford one, one be appointed by the court. You understand the rights I have right to you?
Yep.
I understand you state that you guys are fishing, sir, but this isn't a legal way of doing it, okay? And right now, you're pretty lucky that you're not dealing with the wildlife troopers, because that's pretty much the laws they enforce. Fish and wildlife.
Ooh, so
as well as sporting. It's not mean to be threatening, sir. I'm just giving you a basic knowledge of common sense, okay? So go ahead and step to the back of my car. Go ahead, partner.
Hey, sir. Are you willing to give me your identification?
Nope.
Okay, just stand up for me.
Nope, I'm not standing up.
Stand up. Sir, I'm not going to ask you again to stand up. I'm gonna.
Okay, sir, listen. You need to start cooperating, okay?
I don't, though. I don't want you guys to have a picture of me.
Okay, well, it's going to happen either way, right?
You can do it once
he grabs you by the hand. Okay, sit your ass down. Don't move.
Don't.
Jumps on him.
When we get to the station.
Partner, get the hobbles.
Yep.
Okay, if that's the way you want to play, sir, that's fine. You're going to be sitting in the station until we figure out who you are.
The hat off and the glasses off.
I really don't care.
Yep, takes off the hat and glasses.
Nope, turns head around.
152, can I have a 1023? I'm sending the image on the MDT to the dispatch center.
10-4. Alright, get the hobbles. Let's just put them in the back.
Yep.
Did you let them know his charges, sorry? Or actually wait for the 1023K?
I'll take the 1014.
Go ahead, I'll get the back.
So, what's your guys' names?
Sheriff Soothing Clanson, sir. Badge number 101.
Corporal Mike Clantis, badge number 152.
Partner, get the front door. I'll put him in the back.
Yep.
Puts him in the back.
So, forcefully took my picture. We'll see what the county office thinks about that.
Okay. 152.
152.
It's going to be coming back showing on 1019. Male white, 5'6", brown. Individually is known to be 1099.
Temple. Alright. Okay, greeting star, Corporal Icavantis, like before.
Yeah.
Going for it.
Whatever. Let's just get over with, take me to the station or whatever.
Okay, well, before we can go anywhere, we need to let you know this, so just chill out for me.
Unfortunately,
yes, I know, I have the right to remain silent. I'm being arrested for whatever you said.
I'm stating your charges. Alright, I legally, as a police officer, I have to state your charges and review your rights. Okay, so you're being charged for the following: possession of a weapon while intoxicated, public intoxication, and disorderly conduct.
Mm-hmm. Okay? Mm-hmm.
You have the right to remain silent. Anything you say can and will be against in the court of law. You have the right to consult to an attorney. Not a form will be appointed to by the court. Do you understand these rights?
What? No, I didn't understand.
Okay,
okay,
well,
one more time.
Go ahead one more time if
you
still
have the right to remain silent.
Transport him.
Anything you say can and will be used against you in the court of law. You have the right to consult to an attorney while being questioned. Okay? So anything you say can or be used against you in the court of law. You understand these rights?
What?
Alright, sir. You know what? If you're gonna keep on saying what every time I redo your rights, alright, we're just gonna deal with this at the station. Alright.
101 code 4, transferring 1 to post.
152, same traffic as 101.
10-4. Hey, partner, just watching for speeding vehicles. Whoa. 101, I have a vehicle that just sped past me. It's gonna be a black four-door sedan. It's gonna be northbound Harmony, West Harmony. We're attempting to catch up now.
152, same traffic as 101.
Appears to be a failure to yield at this time. The individual is currently westbound Ford Zancudo, Route 68 approach. Oh, Jesus.
152 second, they're in pursuit at this time.
Hard time keeping up to the individuals continuing westbound. We may have to discontinue. Advise, getting too dangerous. We've reached speeds of 100 miles an hour.
One 152 shots fired on my vehicle at this time. 1020 is going to be Zancudo Grande Valley. 152, be advised. I believe it's at the closed door at this time and behind it. 152 direct to 101, be careful. I just heard shots come from around that area.
10-4 units, let's go ahead and set up a perimeter.
152 to 101, I'm gonna cover this area right here on this side.
10-4.
152, I advise on the black sedan at this time. I advise on the individual. 152 shots fired on my vehicle. It's going to be on the west side at this time. 152 to 101, try to flank him.
Where is he? Shots fired! Sheriff's office, drop the gun! Hold fire, hold fire. He's down.
Jeez.
Partner, you good?
Yup, I'm good. You good?
Yep, secure that weapon. I'm gonna get the vehicle.
Here's weapon.
As I'm searching the vehicle, what do I find?
Two AKs and a shotgun.
Whoa.
Partner, we have additional weapons here.
Now this guy's like ready for a war.
101, dispatch advise, we're code 4 suspects down, roll corners and medics to our 1020.